Okay, so in this screencast, I'm going to make a color box. So to do that, I click on guide, my window comes up, I want to make a blank GUI, and here's my GUI that I'm going to be designing in. Alright, so I could probably do it with another object, but for now I can use this axes type object to use for my colors. I can use a slider bar for red, make it that big, say. I'll copy that and I'll paste it for blue, paste it for green. I'm not too worried for now about how neat this looks because I'll play around with that later. I'll also have some edit boxes over here. It's one, it's two, and there's three. Okay, so my objects are now set up. This is all I want for my GUI. Okay, now I should give these meaningful names. So I go into my property inspector. And where is the tag? So I'll say this is my color window. By default, it shouldn't display anything. And just to demonstrate that, I'll click on this run figure. It warns me to save my changes. So yes, I want to save that. And I'm going to save this as color box. MATLAB up. Updates itself with the code that corresponds to my new GUI, and here's my figure. So I've renamed the tag of the color window. Now I have to rename the tag of all my sliders. So the first slider is slider 1. I want to make this my red slider. I'll make this my blue slider. Sorry, green slider. And my blue slider. I won't worry about the edit boxes for now. Let's just get something working. Now you'll notice in the code that it still refers to slider 1, slider 2, slider 3. If I save this now, the code will actually update itself such that it now refers to blue slider, green slider, and red slider. So MATLAB's guide is very nice like that. Okay? So this is how we set up our GUI to use for the first time.